Ladies and gentlemen, West Michigan Aviation Academy guests, welcome. We ask that you please stand for our national anthem.
You see, my youngest daughter, Ellie, also happens to be graduating right now. And so I will be exiting and driving very slowly to get to her graduation. I wanted you to know, though, that my mama kids will be in my heart tonight. Parents, guardians, grandparents, the encouragement that you have offered these young people during their challenging moments does not go unnoticed. You are part of the reason why these young people are getting their diplomas this evening. Graduates, look around you. Look at how many people have come to witness this special time for you. WAMA faculty and staff, can you please stand for a moment? Along with that, I'd like to give a special shout out to Mr. Larry Fisher and Mr. Maurice Gross. Could you also stand? These are the people that have wrapped around these students over their high school journey. Team, you have held these students accountable. You have cared for them. You have sat next to them when there were tears. You have shared your talents and your passion on a daily basis, and I thank you. What you're seeing right now is a symbolic wraparound over our graduates. We had to wrap around them one last time before we turned them over to this world. You may be seated. Class of 2022, you have explored so many things during your high school career. You've explored things that you didn't even know you would get to. And you did that maybe because you felt like taking those healthy risks or because you were encouraged by somebody else. These are those experiences that you get to take on with you as you start your next chapter. We're really proud because we know you're equipped. You've participated in Socratic seminars. You know how to have civil discourse. You understand the importance of looking and vetting at sources of information. Thank you, English and history teachers. You understand that sometimes you think you're not interested in something, but actually once you try it, you realize you are. Perhaps that came to you during your engineering courses. Perhaps you fell in love with history. You're equipped with a professional lifelong skills that you will take anywhere you go in this world. You know how to make direct professional eye contact. I've witnessed it over the years. I've watched you come in our doors as freshmen, where you tried to act like I wasn't standing there. And over the years, you got more and more comfortable. And that is a skill that's going to make a difference for you. You know how to give firm handshakes, even though we had to take a break from them for a short while. You understand the impressions that you make when you first meet someone, and that the details matter. You understand what happens when you walk on our WAMA logo on our rugs. Some of you learn the hard way. You also know what it feels like when you meet someone for the first time and you get to introduce yourself and they're astounded because you, as a young adult, interact with guests that come in our building as if you were an adult. And some of you know how to fly airplanes, and you do, and you're gonna keep doing it. As I look out onto you, I see so much accomplishment, but I also see great hope. I see a student body who has had the opportunity to navigate challenges and celebrations. And you continue to model the WAMA way. I see a collective group of extraordinary individuals, mature thinkers, and young ladies and gentlemen with integrity. As you reflect on your time at WAMA and all that you've done here, whether it's from abroad experiences or by serving in neighboring communities, all of that learning and all of that leading that you've done, I want you to take that with you. That, along with your own family values, have shaped you as individuals. You've also been transformed by your peers, and you've been inspired by those that have gone before you. We wish you the greatest of happiness and progress as you begin your next chapter, wherever that may take you. And just know that you are WAMA. You are WAMA. And that comes with great responsibility. Congratulations, class of 2022. Everyone, and welcome to West Michigan Aviation Academy's Class of 2022 graduation ceremony. My name is Elsa Nowak, and I am one of the senior class representatives helping to introduce tonight's event.
And my name is Jocelyn Jarko. I am also a senior class representative. We are so delighted to have you all here and to be able to have you all here in person to help celebrate the class's accomplishments.
While photography is welcome and appreciated, we ask that you use some of this time to silence any devices and turn off the flash to limit distractions and help this ceremony go as smoothly as possible. Thank you.
We would like to reiterate how excited we are to have everyone here tonight. The past 3 years of our high school experience have been bumpier than most, to say the least. So much of our academic career here has been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. No assemblies, no dances, limited sports and clubs, and at times not even being able to talk to people in person.
In light of COVID, we have gotten to witness firsthand how students, faculty, staff, and parents have worked to overcome so many challenges in order to still achieve a quality education in this institution of bright and successful individuals. Studying virtually, changing class schedules around, and teaching and learning while masked are just a few of the challenges overcome by this resilient school.
And while some of our traditions may have waned during the quarantine and the resulting months of social distancing, this year we have managed to have a whole school assembly and spring formal dance for the first time in 2.5 years. Events like this commencement that we once took for granted, this class of 2022 sees as something special. One of our unique traditions is new student orientation for incoming freshmen. It is usually a week-long event complete with team building activities, some testing, and some early volunteering opportunities. I was one of the upperclassmen fortunate enough to co-lead a group of these incoming freshmen this past year. The first year we could truly do it properly since our own class's freshman year. This is such a unique experience that our school provides and something we are lucky to have. When COVID happened, it wasn't able to be as open as it was in the past, but it offers the opportunity for incoming freshmen to foster connection to their classmates and their school, while allowing us to display the leadership qualities they aspire towards. I was so happy to be able to offer support to that class and participate in one of the school's special events.
This year, we have also gotten the amazing chance to add more traditions to the school. One such example was Senior Sunset. For those of you who haven't heard the event, a Senior Sunset is an opportunity for the senior class to get together with the added benefit of photos. Our senior sunset took place at Holland Beach following the last day of school, and it was a great chance for the senior student council to put together a no-stress gathering before graduation. It was a beautiful day, and I would say a great success, and I would definitely recommend that the juniors take the opportunity to plan a similar event for their senior year. So, as the commencement ceremony here commences, remember not simply the complications and upheaval of the past years, but how this group of illustrious students have overcome them with the help and guidance of many here tonight. Think of the achievements, the triumphs, and relish the ability to be here with us here today.
As a quick preview of tonight's program, next we will hear from the class's president's remarks and the recognition of the class of 2022's top 10 students, followed by the tassel ceremony. We will be finishing today with closing remarks from our senior vice president.
Let's graduate.
Good evening. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Sebastian Rojas, our senior class president. And I've always prided myself on being a little all over the place. And as I wrote this speech, I struggled. Would it be sappy and heartfelt? Would it be funny? Would I try and impart some lasting wisdom on the class of 22? It really did take a while to figure out. Even though over the past 4 years I had learned so much, I struggled to put it into concise words. And then I recalled one particular story, one I like to recount a lot. During last summer, along with a group of peers, I led some of the freshman class and incoming students in their new student orientation. As the day progressed, I talked to a lot of the incoming freshmen, and I took pride in giving them the scoop. What teachers they could mess with, how to hide their AirPods underneath their hair, all the necessities. But as the day rounded out, we had to teach the freshmen how to open their lockers. Now, over the past 4 years, I've been taught how to do triple integrals. I've been taught the process of glycolysis production. And I even worked on a carbon cub EX2 with the Build-A-Plane class. And yet, it got to that day, and I realized I didn't know how to open a locker. So I asked a freshman to teach me. It definitely wasn't my proudest moment, that's for sure. But it did teach me a valuable lesson. And no, it wasn't how to open a locker. Unfortunately, I still can't remember how to do that. However, it did teach me that education is all around us, if you're willing to see it. Many of us may be going to college, or the military, or some post-secondary institution, and some may be going straight to the workforce. But for none of us does this night mark the end of our education. It was 19th century philosopher and educator John Dewey who said, "Education is not preparation for life, education is life itself." As we leave this ceremony, I ask all of you to consider that. High school may not have been your forte, but do not let that taint the wonders of learning or living. In other words, just because you failed trig, that does not mean you can't learn how to enjoy life. Before I conclude, I'd like to thank the teachers, administrators, faculty, and staff, for without them these past 4 years wouldn't have been possible. Your countless hours behind the scenes working to further our education does not go unnoticed. To the family and friends in the crowd, on behalf of the graduating class of 2022, I'd like to thank you as well. Just your presence here tonight is appreciated, and the support you've lent us throughout our high school journey cannot be understated. Lastly, I'd like to invite the class of 22 to take a breath, take it all in. This is your high school graduation, the culmination of 4 years of early mornings, late nights, and sleeping through classes. So, class of 22, for today, congratulations. For tomorrow, good luck. And forever, go Aviators. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Caitlin Lewis, and I've had the pleasure of being these seniors' English teacher, the majority of them, this past year. Before we begin, I wanted to just take a moment so we could honor and recognize not only those who are physically gathered in this space, but also those who are with us in spirit or in our hearts tonight. We thank you for your presence. And we thank you for the influence you've had on these wonderful young adults seated before me. Now, seniors, you know it wouldn't be a last lesson if we didn't start off with three pieces of good news. So here's good news piece number one. I've really missed you this week, and I'm so grateful that I just get to see your smiley faces today. Which leads me to good news piece number two. You, I'm speaking for all of us, when we say we are so grateful for every single one of you. We are proud of you, we are amazed by you, we are humbled by you. And finally, good news piece number three, I've timed my speech, and we only have about 5 minutes before it's done, so we get to see you walk across this stage, receive your diplomas, turn your tassels, and recess out of here as the empowered young adults we know you to be. For old time's sakes, and loved ones, family members, friends, feel free to join in if you'd like. Let's clap out our good news on three. On seniors, one, two, three. All right, loves, here it is, the final keeping of the house note. Remember to control what you can, Remember to have compassion for yourself and others. And remember just how capable each of you are at making our world a brighter, kinder, more loving place. In case you needed it, here's some evidence from the past 4 years to support how you've already demonstrated it. Year one, you came to WAMA from a variety of other schooling experiences, not knowing many of your teachers, administrators, or peers when you did so. Yet, you navigated that transition, you began to figure out what high school was all about, and more importantly, you began to figure out who you wanted to be as young adults. Year two, you progressed to your sophomore year, you had some experience under your belts, and you thought you had it all figured out. And then along came COVID-19 and all that that entailed. Yet in year three, we then came back to a hybrid online and in-person format with a new schedule, a new online learning system, new procedures, pretty much new everywhere around us. And with all that new, you still had the newness of beginning to figure out what you wanted to do post-WAMA and then taking actual steps towards that. Year four. Yet again, you navigated a lot of new. We had a new building, a new schedule, more new procedures, and through all that new, you were the class that set the standard and example for others to follow. You were the class that revamped our school spirit, whether it was through the creative, fun, and sometimes wild lift video announcements you made, the flight crew student section, the homecoming swirl and formal dances that you made sure were put on and that others were invited to and had a good time at, and the numerous other student-led activities you organized. You did that. And through all of this, you were still continuing to figure out your core values, and what was really cool is we got to see you living those out intentionally in your day-to-day. And I'd be remiss if I didn't also mention in the past 4 years, this class specifically has had to endure tremendous loss and adversity. The loss of peers, the loss of loved ones, the loss of structures you were used to, high school experiences and opportunities you may have pictured for yourself, and the list could go on. Yet, what's clear is that in each year, you controlled what you could, you did it with compassion for yourself and with others in mind, and in so doing, you demonstrated just how capable you are of making our world a brighter, kinder, more loving place. For example, you controlled what you could because you chose to put your best effort in each and every day. You prioritized your values, you realized the importance of asking for help, and you sought support as you needed. You formed lasting and sustainable friendships and relationships with those who would encourage and empower you. In other words, you were just making the best of every single situation. And you also did this while having compassion for yourself and for others in mind. You realized just how much adversity and how much new you were battling on a daily basis. So you gave yourself and others grace as you honed your resiliency, you overcame those obstacles, and you embodied a growth mindset through it all. To quote Samwise Gamgee, you found the good that's worth fighting for, and you fought for it amidst those tumultuous times by intentionally reaching out to your friends and intentionally finding ways to bring joy to not only yourself, but to others. And lastly, you demonstrated how capable you are. The choices and decisions you've made over the course of these 4 years proves this. To quote Tolkien again, as Frodo is lamenting the hardships he's faced, Gandalf provides him with some wisdom. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that's given to us. Seniors, almost graduates, the choices you've made are that you've decided to control what you could, and you did that with compassion for yourself and others in mind. You've chosen resilience, perseverance, grit, empathy, courage when it would have been far easier not to. And as Albus Dumbledore says to Harry Potter, it's our choices that show us who we truly are, far more than our abilities. Your choices have shown me, have shown all of us. You are capable of making a difference in this world. You are capable of making it brighter, kinder, more loving for everyone. And don't worry, I know that sometimes we benefit from reminders. So underneath your chairs, you'll find a set of sticky notes. And on that top one, I've left a message for each of you so that you will always remember this final keeping of the house note. Congratulations, class of 2022. And as always, be safe, make good choices.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hayden Lean here, and I'm our senior class treasurer. And today, Joey and Riebel and I are here to announce the class of 2022 academic top 10. These 10 students had the highest weighted GPA in our senior class. What it means to be in the academic top 10 is to go above and beyond standard high school expectations. Since we aren't a standard high school, it's more difficult to get into these top 10 spots. At WAMA, it seems like half the grade is taking AP or honors classes, which makes for a lot more competition.
Now let's get to know these students. These students made their schedules very challenging to get this spot today, with enough AP and honors classes through their 8 semesters to separate themselves from the rest of the class. Also, many of these students challenged themselves with extracurricular activities throughout their time in high school. With all these challenges, these are the students that came out on top. The top 10 students will be announced in alphabetical order. Kevin Bartek.
The second is Devin Krishner.
Raven Sidley.
Kathleen Grace Hewitt.
Kat Hogan.
Maya Kaywin.
Thomas Krampitz.
Taylor Lane.
Elsa Nowak.
And I'm sure we're all surprised by this one, Jimmy Sylvester.
Congratulations to our academic top 10.
Good evening, my name is George Pavey. I'm the Dean of Aviation and Engineering. I have the distinct honor of recognizing our graduates that have earned their FAA private pilot license. I kind of feel remiss as the Dean of Aviation if I didn't remind everyone that tonight is the premiere of the sequel of the movie Top Gun. I do feel like I have to dispel a myth about call signs and fighter pilots in general, okay? So call signs are really meant to keep a pilot's ego in check. We don't have Maverick, Goose, and Iceman among us. We have like Slice and Pledge and some really funny stories that go along with them, which I'm sure those two individuals hope that I don't tell you the story. So with that, I would like to share a saying among carrier-based naval aviators and how it relates to life. The saying is, fly fast, turn hard, and catch a three-wire. Fly fast. To pilots, speed is life. You only get one chance at life, so make it count. Challenge yourself to be something more. Don't accept no for an answer. And if you don't ask, you're telling yourself no. We have some experts at this in this room. Turn hard. Pulling 7 G's is painful. At times your life will be painful, but it's part of the flight plan. As a fighter pilot, we use a G suit to help sustain the challenges of pulling G's. Rely on your family and your friends to see you through the tough times. Catch a three wire. Every landing on an aircraft carrier is graded. Every landing. No mulligans, no do-overs. There are 4 wires on a flight deck. Catching on a 1 wire gets you a no grade, gets you an F. If you do it bad enough, you get to visit the air boss. Not fun, not pleasant. Thankfully, I never had to do that. Avoid the visits to the air boss. Catching a 2 wire is considered a fair pass, average. Anybody want an average pilot? I didn't think so. Let's avoid being average in life. Catching a 4 wire is your last chance. If you miss the 4 wire, you have no chance of landing, resulting in an opportunity to do it again because you weren't good enough. You didn't measure up. Let's do it right the first time. Now, catching the coveted 3 wire, an okay pass, an A+. True excellence. At WAMA, the 3 wire represents being ladies and gentlemen of high moral character, of treating others the way you want to be treated, the relentless pursuit of excellence, all of which will serve you well in life. So graduates, strive to catch a 3 wire. At this time, I'd like the following class of 2022 graduates stand in place and be recognized for achieving our capstone opportunity of becoming a private pilot. Please remain standing until the end. Kevin Bartek, Aubrey Bogardis, Charles Brower, Devin Christner, Alexander Day, Zachary Gulch, Kat Hogan, Karsten Kotchenreuther, Cooper Marchukaitis, Elliot McNutt, Ryan Minnick, Jonathan Patterson, Zeke Robahat, Hayden Smith, Aris Tarchinski. Not to be overlooked, I would like to invite Tatiana Marsh, Samantha Benoit, to stand and be recognized for soloing. The courage, the persistence, the skill to solo is something only few understand. Welcome to the club. Congratulations to all of our pilots, and please join me in a big round of applause.
Good evening. My name is Kat Hogan, and tonight I will be performing Vienna by Billy Joel. So please enjoy. Once the hurry for your time, although it's so romantic on the borderline tonight, tonight. Too bad, but it's the life you lead. You're so ahead of yourself that you forgot what you need. Though you can see when you're wrong, you know you can't always see when you're right. You're right. You've got your passion, you've got your pride.
Thank you very much, Kat. That was terrific. On behalf of the Board of Directors of the Aviation Academy, I want to congratulate all of our graduates this evening. And I want to also take a moment to thank parents, grandparents, and family who have trusted us with your young person. Now, if you're not familiar with the fact that West Michigan Aviation Academy is a charter school, that means you chose us. And we had to earn your trust to keep your child and to keep your family attached to this school. There's something powerful in having that choice. And we don't take that lightly as a board of directors or as a faculty or staff. We earned that trust, and we hope we earned it every day, and we hope that our students felt that as well. I do want to especially thank our faculty and our staff that are here sitting around. This is an extraordinary group of educators, and I just, for parents and, again, for those of parents and family and friends, this is an exceptional group. Not only are they talented, but they're very, very dedicated. And I think you saw a little bit of that tonight. Dedicated to your child. Dedicated to not just to helping them learn the books, but to learn also about life and what's really important. So I want to thank the faculty and staff, and finally our thanks to the board, some of whom are represented here. Not all of our board members were able to make it this evening, but the board meets on a regular basis, provides a direction to the school. It's a significant responsibility, and so I want to say my thanks to the board members who freely give of their time to our school. And then finally, students, I just want to remind you that in addition to all of the groups that I've mentioned, your family, the faculty and staff, the board, there's a lot of people who invested in you in addition. You know, some of you helped us out the other night at the gala, where we helped to raise money. You know, in addition to the amount of money that we get from the state of Michigan, We ask donors to come and join us and freely contribute to add some of the extra things that were talked about, to add in the things like the freshman orientation programs, a lot of the aviation and engineering programs that we do that the state doesn't pay for. And so in addition, there's a lot of people you have never met who have invested in your education as well. So this is serious stuff. There's a lot of people invested in you. And we're hoping that you'll take that seriously as you look forward. You know, I probably can't help myself. There's been a lot of advice given, and you know, graduations are about giving advice, and so I won't restrain from giving my little perspective as well. You've gotten some good comments, some great comments. I love catching a three-wire. I haven't been able to do it, but I'd love to do that. The reality is that I'm really glad, Sebastian, that you can still make it in life after failing trig. That's been a real encouragement to me because I wasn't exactly a math major, so just saying. In addition to flying aircraft, which is one of my passions, one of my other passions is skiing, snow skiing. I really enjoy being in the mountains and snow skiing, and especially if you're a snow skier, you realize that the most magic day on a ski slope is a powder day, where you have fresh powder on the hill, and this beautiful white snow is laid before you, not a track in it, and you get to be the first one to make those turns. Well, I was learned a valuable life lesson that I want to share with all of you, even if you're not a skier. I was standing on the top of a hill with a gentleman I'd skied with for many years, a very talented skier. He'd taken us to a particular spot that he liked very much. And as we stood on the top of the hill looking down at this beautiful snow, I made an observation that wasn't particularly astute. I said, "My goodness, there's a lot of trees on this hill. What's up with that?" He said to me, "Dick," he said, "you see trees? You know what I see? I see a lot of openings. Let's go ski in the openings." Seems kind of silly, doesn't it? But the truth of it is, as soon as I shifted my focus and started to look for openings and not look at trees, I saw lots of openings. In fact, as I began to ski down the hill, I realized I didn't even see the trees around me. I was so focused on openings. I was skiing so close to trees, I hardly ever saw them. I was just looking for the next opening, the next opportunity. So my encouragement to you graduates, skier or not, look for the openings. It's easy to see the trees in life. But when you see trees, remember, there's also openings. Find the opening and go out, and what was said before, go out and make a difference. We're proud of you. We're proud that you chose this school. You will be an aviator forever. And know that you're always, always welcome back at WAMA. We look forward to seeing you. Come back and see us. Tell us your stories, all right? So I get to do another thing here tonight that I normally don't do because Mrs. Gasper is attending to her parental responsibilities. And so I'm able to read a statement, and it says, "By the authority bestowed upon me as the chairman or the president of the board of directors of the Michigan Aviation Academy by the state of Michigan and the West Michigan Aviation Academy's board of directors, I certify that all members of the class of 2022 receiving their diploma tonight have met or exceeded the established graduation requirements." Congratulations, class of 2022. Find the openings.
Sebastian Rojas Garcia. Thomas Edward Krampitz. Daniel Heath Fenton. Hayden Robert Leanhear. James Roger Sylvester. Eli William McGuire Stevenson. Matthew Robert Kleinstra. Katarina Roxanne Hogan. Devin Nicole Christner. Kevin Christopher Bartek. William Elliott McNutt. Tam Nhao Nguyen. Warner John Jackson. Aris Wesley Tarchinski. Sydney Rayana Flynn. Charles Benson Dan. Ian Carlos Santoyo. Kiara Haiti Roble. Elizabeth Joy Joling. Jocelyn Caroline Jarko. Elsa Jean Nowak. Sophia Rosalie Witters. Kathleen Grace Hewitt. Chase Garrison Powell. Zachary Gerald Gulch. Christopher Walker Lehman. Michael Aaron Cromwell Jr. Happy Nicole Batches. Jacob Michael Snyder. Sean Michael Spellman. Gavin Dale Longcore. Ava Elizabeth Dixon. Ava Rose Bont. Joseph Michael Riebel. Zakaria Saeed Mohammed. Jonas William Bont. Hayden Agapito Kimball. Hunter Thomas Norman. Reese Douglas Hunderman. Brandon Lee Telkamp. James Isaac John Miller. Nancy Vicario. Ray Nalani Swedwa. Caitlin Juplin Dang. Sydney Paige Turk. Lauren Elizabeth Asbury. Kendra Lauren Kuiper. Taylor Nicole Lane. Tyler John Kramer. Harrison Frederick Jones. Jaden Paul Brower. Carter David Morehouse. Aiden Joseph Story. Luke Philip Bruning. Jackson Bennett Mallory. Nicholas Allen J. Quick. Kungo Rita Yula Eunice Giarasuba. Selma Salim Eljaburi. Sophia Leanne Johnson. Sahara Mohammed Abdullahi. Jennifer Gamino Alvarez. Sarah Mackenzie Abigail Renee Tristan Anderson. Mason Metali Dion. Nathaniel Kevin Brown. Charles Jacob Brower. Jonathan Glenn Patterson. Ryan Jacob Minnick. Cooper Anthony Marchikaitis. Aubrey Joy Bogardis. Kaylin Liu. Emma Elizabeth Hazelton. Montserrat Quintino. Kirsta Marie Edwards. Sithara Indrani Nanjapa. Leah Rose Kaufman. Carly Elizabeth Alvesteffer. Alexander James Day. Karsten James Kochenreuther. Zamarion Shalom Jones. Zaid S. Rabahat. Colin Mitchell Markwart. Colton Allen Holmes. Dang Kwok Nguyen. Olivia Joe Headley. Maxwell Thomas Frigeris. Titan Matthew Terberg. Elijah William Lehrer. Elijah Patrick Fortino. Ethan Cole Beatty. Corin Lee Bazzani. Joshua Dean Hornstra. Cecilia Jewel Gray. Nicholas Robert James. Philip Thomas Spears. Spencer Richard Bauman. Joshua Robert Beatty. Justice King Ambersley. Zion Atlan Ambersley. Abigail Jane Vandenhoek. Lauren Elizabeth Swain. Martha Kiamasuku Kalambula. Samantha Grace Benoit. Tatiana Joelle Marsh. Ahmed Mohammed Saeed. Chris DiBaggio Hernandez Lopez. Zakaria Ahmed Mohammed. Jaden Michael Kelly. Victor Hugo Gutierrez. Isaiah Harrison Port. Justin Wade Daniels. Zachary Michael Eggleton. Kaylee Rihanna Broyles. Sidlali Martinez Perez. Benjamin Scott Klopfenstein. Elizabeth Lauren Buckley. Kendall Renee Ruth Springborn. Zamzam Eleanor Eunice. Caleb Dunsmore Kelling. Jeremiah Lee Bauma. Gabriel Elazar Wade. Hayden Avery Smith. George Jimmy Amash. Derek Tarek Mendoza. John Pavelic Morales. Allison Grace Woodhouse. Maya Elizabeth Kerwin. Raven Clark Silly. Anthony Donald J. Malinowski. Emily Ray Proxmire. Jesse Dean Bott. Joshua Robert Mayo. Jacob Taylor Johnson. Adriano John Hanning. Elijah Allen Klusterman. Hunter Edward Fields. Jacob Andrew Burke. And accepting the WAMA Honorary Diploma for Andrew Andy Lee Larson is Caleb Kelling, and he will be presenting it to Andy's parents, Marcy and Eric Larson. Nobody wanted to be an aviator more than Andy, and our thoughts are with his family this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 22.
I want to start by saying thank you to all the students, teachers, parents, and staff who helped make these last 4 years everything they were. My name is Thomas Krampus, and I'm the Secretary of the Senior Student Council. I stand here before you looking back on 4 years of a legacy we've all made together. No individual person would have been able to make the impact that we did at the school. Each and every one of us helped contribute to making that happen in our own way, whether that was through a sports team, a club, or simply by just showing up every day ready to learn. Overall, every single one of us have helped change this school for the better. When I first arrived at WAMA, I never would have imagined how much this school would change my life in such a short time. 4 years may seem like a lifetime when living it, but it feels as though it went by in a blink of an eye. It feels just like yesterday I walked through the doors for the first time as a freshman, ready to start learning and start the next chapter of my life. It's experiences we've made during these last 4 years of our life that have helped define who we are as a person today. Whether those experiences were through the amazing staff we had, who always went above and beyond to help ensure we had the best education we could have dreamed for, or simply through the relationships we built. It's the people we surround ourselves with the most that help determine who we are. At this school, I have met some of the most amazing people who have helped make me the person I am today. Freshman year, I never would have imagined myself being here giving this speech. But if there's one thing that I've learned from this school, it's that when you push yourself to do better and set your standards higher, you'll be able to accomplish more than you ever thought possible. Now at this time, I ask that every student stand. Please join me in moving the tassel from the right side of your cap to the left. Moving the tassel signifies both the closing and the beginning of a new chapter in each of our lives. When looking at the tassel, you can see the many different strands that all come together as one. Looking at our futures, each of us is going in our own journey, but every road can trace back to this high school and everything that it has taught us. It has meant a lot to be surrounded by all of you for the last 4 years. On the horizon, there's a new chapter of our lives waiting for us, and it's more incredible than we could have ever imagined. Seniors, please sit. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Dan Fenton, Vice President of the Senior Class.
As we close today's ceremony, I have a few final remarks, once again thanking everyone who has helped us come to where we are today, particularly thanking the faculty, board, and staff members here at West Michigan Aviation Academy. Extraordinary instructors like Mrs. Lewis, with her awe-inspiring dedication to the senior class and class's well-being. Miss Brianna Bailey and her unforgettable moments inside and outside of the classroom. Miss Gasper's consistent morning greeting. And of course, Mr. Fay's, Mr. Forney's, and Mr. Pavey's always present sense of humor. There's just too many unique and astounding staff members and not enough time to go mention them all. The contributions made by them have been so valuable in our journey to this day of celebration. Moreover, I'd like to give a final thank you to the class of 2022 for making the last 4 years memorable and enjoyable. I knew that when I arrived late to my first day of freshman orientation, I immediately knew that the building in front of me was that of lofty academic goals. But not only that, but one where communities could be found easily and prosper. To me personally, West Michigan Aviation Academy offers the opportunity to easily meet and interact with people who have impacted me in indescribable ways. While extracurricular sports are often an afterthought due to them being overshadowed by the other remarkable programs here, I firmly believe that the camaraderie provided by sports such as track and field, basketball, and cross country leave a special impact on a person. I know they have with me. Similarly, a more academic camaraderie was provided to me by the hands-on, group-oriented learning environment present in the school, such as in the engineering department. I hope that my legacy here on the school and on the class of 2022 is similar to the legacy that is left on me. While this legacy won't be some grand gesture like a building named after me, yet, I hope that my legacy is one in the culture of the school, in its underclassmen, and in its graduates. Even through the trials and tribulations of the past 4 years, we have stood strong and stayed on top. As we go forth from today, I would like to focus on a quote from Jim Henson, or more specifically from Kermit the Frog. Life is like a movie, choose your own ending. I chose this quote specifically because of its emphasis on the control that you have over your future. However, there's a second section of that quote from the Muppet movie, and it goes, "We've done just what we set out to do," which we have. "Thank you to the lovers, the dreamers, and you." I now invite the graduating class to stand up. Good evening, and congratulations, graduates.